So now the one other thing that seems to be associated with these headings is the spacing. So there's a bit more space between the text and the border and the element below it. To understand how we should add this space, let's go to the lower right-hand corner and scroll down to the very bottom. So you've seen this before. This was how we demonstrated earlier that every element on a page is a box. Now each element has multiple layers, and how these fit together is called the box model. We begin in the middle with the actual element, so in this case it's our heading. Around our heading we can set padding. In this case we don't have any yet, but we're about to add some. And then around the padding goes the border. And you can see the yellow line underneath the qualities now, which is showing us where our border is. Now around the border layer here, you see this dark black border. That indicates the absolute edge of the element. So the edge of the element is the actual size of the element, plus the padding, plus the border. So if our original element was 34 pixels tall, which it says here, we would add one more pixel to it for that border, and then we would get the actual size of it, which will be 35 pixels. Outside of the element, we can define the margin, which is the amount of space that should exist between this element and other elements, either above, below, or to the sides of it. In this case, it's showing us that the margin is 28.22 pixels. And you can see the orange above and below, which shows us just how big that is. And you can see that the space here between the two qualities headings aligns with that 28 pixels here. And that space begins after the border down here, and it begins up here at the actual edge of the element. So this margin above is keeping it from the qualities image right here, and the margin below is keeping it from the next heading. Now what's interesting is that if we highlight another heading, you can see that the margin above is the 28 pixels, which we have down there, but it overlaps with the margin that was below the element above it. So what margin is actually telling us is that we want at least this amount of space between the elements. In this case, the default in the browser is 28.22 pixels. But let's say we took this first heading, and I'm going to highlight it, and I'm going to scroll up here in the styles, and I'm going to edit this element so it has a different bottom margin. And I'm going to go margin, bottom, and we'll set it to 40 pixels. You can see that the space increases between these two, because 40 pixels is the bigger size of margin, but it's not going to add the 40 pixels to whatever this second heading has. If we scroll down, we can see it again, the 28.22 pixels. It's not going to add them together. Instead, it will pick the bigger number and make that the margin. So if we go back to our mockup and we'll zoom into 100%, we want some space right here. Let's measure how much. So I'm going to go down here. So about 28 pixels between the bottom of the text and the border. And then between the border and the next element, we're going to want about 32 pixels. So let's define that. So back in the browser, we'll go to the styles for this heading, and I'll scroll up down here in the lower left-hand corner, and we'll remove this specific styling for this element, because what we're adjusting now is the margin and padding for all of the H2 headings. And now margin and padding both work like border in that we can specify a dash bottom to apply the margin or padding to the bottom, dash top to do the top, right or left, or we can merge them all together in one shorthand property called either margin or padding. So let's test this out in the browser before we apply it to our code. So I'm going to click on this last value, and we'll handle padding first. Now padding will affect the space between the text and the border. So let's do padding bottom, and we'll set it to, it was 28 pixels, and that's starting to look pretty good. Now I'll hit tab to go to the next line, and now we'll add margin, which will add space between the bottom of the border and the top of the next element. So we'll do margin bottom, and we'll make it 32 pixels. And now if you look up here, the spacing looks about right with what we see in the mockup. Now let's add these last two properties to our code. So we'll do padding bottom, 28 pixels, and we'll do margin bottom, 32 pixels, and we'll save this. Let's refresh in the browser to make sure our change is applied, and it looks good.